Squeeze a bend. You know it. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pamela, you're a pro. Bending over slightly. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. I spoke too soon. Here we go. Nice and slow. 5, 6, 7, 8. That's okay. If you make a mistake, just do it nice and slow and get it right. We don't want any injuries. 10 more. 1, 2. We're breathing normally. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and great. Now I'm going to take the sticks. Let's put the sticks down. Arms out to the side for some arm rolls. Hands are fisted. Let's go for 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Great for the arms. Loosening everything up because we're going to have a real good workout today. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stomach tight. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Backwards. How you feeling, pal?
Good.
2, 3, 4, 5. The girls at work watching you this morning?
Yeah.
7, 8, 9. 10. Oh, she's so meek. I'm sure she's just like that at the hospital. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and good. Right here. Here we go. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to do a little extra warm-up today because it's very important. A lot of people are warming up out there. You got to warm up. I don't want you getting hurt. Very important. Come on. Try it. This is also great for the waist, hips, and lower back. Now, remember, we're not swinging. It's just nice and tight. Stomach's tight. Perfect. Hands are fisted. Let's go down to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, let's go like this. 7, 8, 9, 10. The J-gets. Here we go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And great. Now, clasp the thumb, right? Going to reach over the side. Hold it for a 5 count. Hold it for a 5 count. 1, 2, 3, 4. And great. Side. Really stretching out the whole sideline area over here. Knees are bent, taking the pressure off the back, side again. There we go. One more time over the other side. How's everybody feeling? Pamela, you okay? Let's go right down for a Jake run. Here we go. This way, 20 repetitions, here we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep the back nice and streamlined, okay? You don't want to pounce the legs. If you have to, put your weight on the upper part of your body. Let those legs go. Great cardiovascular exercise. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 on the knees for a push-up. Here we go. I like the Bob Barker of exercise, you know?
Yeah.
I'll give you this for that. Let's go. Here we go. 2 and 3. Come on. 4 and 5. Stomach tight. 6 and 7. See, Pamela's doing this perfectly well now. You know why? She's not locking out. Bad for the arms. It's a small move. Right? We're building endurance here as well as we're strengthening our upper body. 500 more, Pamela. I really want to strengthen it. 2, 3, 4, and great. Now, fortissimo burners on the elbows, right? Legs straight out. Here we go. Let's bring it up for 21, 2, 3. Remember, gang, people at home, what I want you to do, don't put weights on your ankles. I don't like that. Resist. Isometric movements, a lot better. Stomach nice and tight. Back is streamlined, breathing normally. 5 more, 1, bring it up. Come on, Pamela, bring it up. 2, 3, 4, and great. Other leg, here we go. Pros out there, right? Our Pro Jake workout armorers. Just keep moving nice and quick. You have to double time the movements if you'd like. Beginners, take your time. Enjoy it. Have fun. Like Pamela's. All right, gang. Now, recently, we've all become more aware of the fact that many pesticides are used in growing our fruits and vegetables. And that some could be very hazardous to our health. Nutritionist and author of Unsafe at Any Meal, Dr. Earl Mindell is here to show us, the gang, how to make our fruits and vegetables safer and healthier. How you doing, Earl?
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Good to see you. Now, what are some of the guidelines you should follow for the family about pesticides?
Well, the first thing is make sure that you wash all your produce and not only wash it, but peel it when it's available. For instance, bananas and oranges should be peeled. Try to grow your own food. Remember the old days used to have the victory gardens? Things taste so much better. I mean,
tomatoes, great, wonderful.
Yeah. And if you can, buy organically grown foods. Talk to your supermarket producer and ask them if you want foods that are free of pesticides and things like that. I think that also you should be aware of looking foods that look too perfect. Because the problem is, like say a tomato, it's kind of rubbery, it looks great, but it doesn't taste as good as say an organic type.
Now, just kind of step back a second.
All right.
Is washing really good? I mean, you really have to wash the fruit?
Yes. As a matter of fact, not only should you wash the fruit, but we're going to show at home what you can do with a banana. Not only should you peel it.
We're gonna eat the banana. No, right? you should wash the banana.
Right, okay. Absolutely.
Now you use a little bit of soap as well.
Right.
Here?
You can use a mild detergent or just soap and water and wash out, because see the residue.
I've never done this before.
I know, but people don't think about this. The residue stays on your finger. Then you peel it.
Okay.
Real simple. Just a dish detergent type.
Now is the skin honestly the most dangerous part?
Absolutely, because for instance, when you the orange has all the pesticides and residues on the skin. And then it's fine.
It's a banana again.
It's a banana.
Now, I'm just having my mouth full. I'm not supposed to, talk my mouth
full. Absolutely.
Fruit that's too perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Because you also mentioned that.
Yes.
There's all kinds of stuff going on in there, right?
I mean,
with apples too shiny.
Well, that's wax. There's no doubt about it.
Okay.
They dip the apples in wax. But even tomatoes, I recommend scrubbing the tomatoes before you even eat them, because the residues stay on, and they're making tomatoes squarer. They fit in the box better.
Really?
Yeah, and the skin is tougher so it doesn't bruise.
Now, this ALR issue has really become very big.
Yes.
What apple products should people be aware of, that they shouldn't deal with?
Well, the big problem, of course, is most of the kids, the infants and younger kids, eat applesauce and eat a lot of apple juice and apples. Buy products, so we have one here that tells you right on the label that it's organically grown apple juice, so that there is no pesticides, no ALR, etc. If it doesn't say so on the label, Jake, then you don't know for sure.
Now, you have a trick about reading labels.
Absolutely.
That's what you always talk
Real
about.
Real simple. It says on this label, organic. This fruit is organically grown and processed in accordance with section so far the California Health and Safety Code, which means that there are no pesticide residues or sprays, etc. I just saw an ad in one of the local papers, a big page, full-page ad, saying that they will not buy apples that are sprayed with ALR or apple juice that has it in it.
Now, talking about vegetables, you would tell me before how many
there
things
are
put
50,
on?
There are 50 sprays that are allowed to be used on broccoli alone. So
when
you buy
really
and broccoli is a great food. But if you buy that, I would lightly cook, steam them, and wash them well, because that gets rid of most of the residue.
So just to, kind of wrap it up a little bit for our gang at home, okay? Gang, it's very simple. With a little extra work, you can protect your family from most of the pesticides used in fruits and vegetables. Be safe. Wash up. Oh, thank you very much.